Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Bradley Pinner. Today I want to discuss why the Watchtower is wrong about the identification of the Lord Jesus Christ being Michael the Archangel. They are not the same. They are two different beings. But they also, the Watchtower says that Michael must be the Lord Jesus Christ because they quote scriptures like Daniel chapter 12 verse 1. It says, at that time, Michael, the great prince who stands watch over your people will rise up. There will be a time of distress such as never occurred since nations became into being until that time. But at that time, all your people who are found written in the book will escape. And they want to quote their works in Watchtower 1984, December 15th, page 29. It says, Michael, the great prince, is none other than Jesus Christ. Now, I want to go back up. I want to back up to, in the same book of Daniel, chapter 10, verse 13. It says, but the prince of the kingdom of Persia opposed me for 21 days. Then Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me. And he says, I have been there with the king of Persia. Now, the fact is, it says that Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help. So if Michael is one of the chief princes, that indicates that Michael is within a group of other chief princes. Michael is not unique in that way because there are other chief princes within his category. But I want to continue on and show you that the Lord Jesus Christ holds a very different title. We can see that to be the case in Revelation chapter 19, verse 11 through 16. It says this, it says, then I saw heaven open, and there was a white horse. Its rider is called Faithful and True, and with justice he judges and makes war. His eyes were like a fiery flame, and he had many crowns on his head. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. He wore a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. The armies that were in heaven followed him on white horses, wearing pure white linen. A sharp sword came from his mouth so that he might strike the nations with it. He will rule them with a rod of iron. He will trample the winepress of the furious anger of God the Almighty. And he has a name written on his robe and on his thigh that reads, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. So let's do a little bit of logic with regard to the structure of a royal family. The prince has authority, but the king has so much more authority. So the fact is that the king is applied to the Lord Jesus Christ, not to Michael the Archangel. We can also see as we continue on that the Lord Jesus Christ forgives sin. We can see that to be the case whenever in Mark chapter 2 he forgives he heals the paralytic and he forgives his sins. And the religious leaders say, you know, who can forgive sins but God? And the fact is, so the scriptures say that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. So the only being that can forgive sins is God, and yet the Lord Jesus Christ did it. And I want to show another example that the Lord Jesus Christ has, he uses the phrase, I am. And if you know your scriptures, you'll know this phrase immediately, because I am is used in Exodus chapter 3 verse 14. Whenever Moses meets with God at the burning bush, it says, God replied to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites, I am has sent me. And the same I am the Lord Jesus Christ uses whenever he uses I am statements. For example, in John 8:58, the scriptures say the Lord saying that before Abraham was, I am. And then the Watchtower says, no, there's no way that could be the same I am that Jesus and Jehovah uses. That's got to be two different ones. We know this to be the case because it says in Let God Be True, page 36 in the original Greek text, this I am differs from the I am in Exodus 3:14 when Jehovah speaks. Now the Septuagint is the Greek translation of the Hebrew Bible. Now the problem for the Watchtower is that this phrase used in John 8:58 is the same phrase used in the Hebrew Bible that the Lord Jesus Christ would have quoted from. And that text, that phrase is ego, I, me, and the Lord Jesus Christ uses it in the New Testament. So when the Lord Jesus Christ uses it in the New Testament, he's saying, I am God, or to put it another way for the witnesses, I am Jehovah. I want to continue on and show you that the Jehovah's Witnesses throw another text to try to prove that Michael and the Lord Jesus Christ are the same being. They used 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 16, and I will quote the whole thing, and they don't seem to do, but I will. It says in 4:16, it says, "For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the archangel's voice, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first." Now, the Watchtower says in Insights on the Scriptures, volume 2, page 393 and 394, in 1 Thessalonians 4:16, they say that the voice of the resurrected Lord Jesus Christ is described as being that of the archangel, suggesting that he is in fact himself the archangel. Now, they leave it at that. They say that because he has the voice of the archangel, he must be the archangel. But they forget to mention the next part of the verse. And a former Jehovah's Witness named David Reed says this when commenting on this. He says that, you know, since the Jehovah's Witnesses want to say that the voice of the archangel proves that he is Michael the archangel, then the Lord Jesus Christ having the trumpet of God makes him God. So you have to have it both ways. You can't just isolate part of the verse and say this is what it means, because the fact of the matter is that the Lord Jesus Christ is divine. Now, I understand that Jehovah's Witnesses will deny this, but the scriptures so clearly show this. The whole totality of the scriptures. And I don't have time to go through all the scriptures, but by and large, they do show this. If you would just take time to discard your New World Translation and pick up a real Bible, you will see this. But I want to continue on and show you that there's another difference between Michael and the Lord Jesus Christ, and it is this fact right here that the Lord Jesus Christ rebukes Satan and Michael does not. For example, we can see in Matthew chapter 16, verse 23, it says, "Jesus turned and told Peter, 'Get behind me, Satan. You are a hindrance to me because you are not thinking about God's concerns, but about human concerns.'" But yet, and I want to make this point very clear, if Michael was the Lord Jesus Christ, then why in the world didn't he rebuke Satan? But we can see in Jude verse 9, it says, "Yet when Michael the archangel was disputing with the devil in an argument about Moses' body, he did not dare utter a slanderous condemnation against him, but he said, 'The Lord rebuke you.'" So, if the Lord Jesus Christ and Michael were the same being, why didn't Michael say, "I rebuke you"? It's because the Lord Jesus Christ and Michael are two different beings. The Lord Jesus Christ is God, whereas Michael is a created being. I want to continue on and show you this as I close. And it's Hebrews chapter 1, verse 5 through 12. It says this. It says, "For which of the angels did he ever say, 'You are my son, today I have became your father,' or again, 'I will be his father and he will be my son'? Again, when he brings his firstborn into the world, he says, 'And let all the angels worship him.'" Now I'm going to stop right there, because the New World Translation right here says obeisance, which is to honor and respect. It's not, but the text doesn't show that. The text shows an act of worship. Throughout the scriptures, the Lord Jesus Christ's apostles and disciples worship him, and he does not turn them away. He does not say, "Don't worship me." He accepts the worship. Why? Because the Lord Jesus Christ is by his very nature God. But he also says, in verse 7, he says, "And about the angels, he says, 'He makes his angels winds and servants a fiery flame,' but to the Son he says, 'Your throne, God, is forever and ever, and the scepter of your kingdom is a scepter of justice. You have loved righteousness and you have hated lawlessness. That is why God your God has anointed you with the oil of joy beyond your companions. And in the beginning, Lord, you established the earth, and the heavens are the works of your hands. They will perish, but you will remain. They will all wear away like clothing. You will roll them up like a cloak, and they will be changed like clothing, but you are the same, and your years will never end." Now here's the thing. This basically the portion of scripture I just provided you, the Hebrews chapter 1 verse 5 through 12, it's Old Testament quotations attributed to Jehovah, but yet in the New Testament they're attributed to Jesus. What does it tell us? It tells us that the Lord Jesus Christ is Jehovah. So I don't want to stress that so much, because it shows us that Michael and the Lord Jesus Christ are so different. They're not the same. They're two different individuals. And I hate to break this to you, Jehovah's Witnesses, but Michael the Archangel worships the Lord Jesus Christ. I would like to thank you for watching this video.